Hi everyone! Hello Y-Rockers! Welcome back again to our live group series this July entitled Roadmap! Yan. And so, for the last 2 weeks, may isang character from the Bible na bidang-bida sa series na to at natatandaan mo pa ba kung sino siya? Siya po ay si Joseph the Dreamer, okay? And we also have been talking about his journey at kung ano yung mga pinagdaanan niya. The first week, di ba, pinag-usapan natin yung topic na the map. And that is all about the visions and the dreams na nag-push kay Joseph para mag-go into a journey. And then last week naman, ang topic na pinag-usapan natin is all about the roads. And with that, we discovered the different roads that Joseph had to go through. And kinompare natin yun sa mga roads na meron din tayo. And for today, we're on our third installment for this series, which is entitled Stop Over. Palakpak naman. Yan, okay. Excited na ako. Okay. And syempre, before tayo mag-dive in sa topic na to, meron muna akong tanong sa inyo. Alam mo ba kung para saan ang brake or preno? I've also been wondering para saan nga ba talaga yung brake na yan. But as I have searched for it, nalaman ko na ang preno or brake pala is by far the most important safety system ng isang vehicle. Bakit kaya? Sabi nila, being able to slow down or stop at a moment's notice will help avoid accident or incident. Therefore, brakes are made as a safety system for the driver to avoid accident. So, ang brake pala is ginawa para iligtas ka. Kaya ka pala hinihiwala yan. De-joke lang. Ano, iba palang brake yon. Pero seryoso, sometimes a moment of stop or a moment to stop or pause can save you from an accident. And that is what we are going to talk about tungkol sa topic na stop over. Ayan. And before we start, alamin muna natin ang ibig sabihin ng stop over. The definition of stopover is a break in a journey, or it is a short stay in a place while in the middle of a tour. Ikaw, have you ever experienced na magbiyahe through any form of vehicle that requires at least 6 hours or more na biyahe? If you will notice kapag ikaw ay uuwi ng probinsya or nung ikaw ay pumunta ng iba sambales, yun yung mga pumunta ng iba sambales dyan, di ba, pagsakay sa bus, through travel time, nagkakaroon tayo ng tinatawag na stopover wherein titigil sila yung mga driver in a specific place to have at least a short break for the passengers and as well for the drivers. Di ba nga tayo ng mga estudyante tayo, kapag may field trip, ang saya-saya na mayroon tayong stopover kasi kakain tayo, tapos para magsi-CR tayo, tapos basta parang ang sarap-sarap mag-stopover muna kasi nagkakaroon tayo ng short break in the middle of a tour. Therefore, during the journey, a pause is also important. And just like in life, if you will always rush yourself to the end, you will miss the lesson in the rest season. Kaya bago pa tayo mag-go deeper sa topic na to, let's pray. Yes, Lord, Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you po for this opportunity, Lord God, to know your word, Panginoon, at matuto, Lord God, mula sa iyo. Lord, ikaw po ang mag-speak through me, Panginoon, at alam mo po na yung makikinig ngayon, Lord God, is mabuksan ang kanilang mga puso, Father God, na talagang ma-grasp po, Panginoon, Lord God, yung importance ng stopover sa buhay, Panginoon. Thank you, Lord. This is all we pray. In Jesus' name, Amen. Okay, so kung ready ka na, arat na! Handa mo na yung mga notes mo at i-ready mo nang i-jot down yung mga mahalagang information ng ating topic. Also, please bear with the chirping sounds kasi dun sa bubong namin may mga nakatirang ibon. Okay? Let's start! Today, we will learn the concept of stopover in the life story of Joseph again. And let us identify kung saang banda siya nagpahinga. Joseph has been entrusted to become the overseer of the house of his masters and everything that he had. Naging favored siya doon, but it doesn't mean na immune na siya sa mga struggles and hardship. At dahil nga pogi si Joseph tulad nung nag-i-speak dito ngayon, di ba? At the wife of his master tried to seduce him, but he resisted. Dahil doon, yung wife tried also to set him up. One day nga, nung si Joseph was going to his work sa isang banda ng bahay ng master niya, At when no one else was there, pinuntahan siya ng asawa ng master niya and tinry na namang isidu si Joseph. But again, he resisted. At ang nangyari doon, the wife got Joseph's cloak and Joseph ran away. And then, the wife shouted, and when the other servants heard and came, she accused Joseph na re-raping daw siya. But when she shouted daw, lumabas na daw or tumakbo na daw si Joseph. At kaya nasa kanya yung cloak ni Joseph. At nung dumating yung master or yung asawa ng wife, he told him what happened. At ito yung nangyari. Genesis 39 verses 19 to 23, ESV version. As soon as his master heard the words that his wife spoke to him, "This is the way your servant treated me," his anger was kindled. And Joseph's master took him and put him into the prison, the place where the king's prisoners were confined, and he was there in prison. But the Lord was with Joseph and showed him steadfast love and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. And the keeper of the prison put Joseph in charge of all the prisoners who were in the prison. Whatever was done there, he was the one who did it. The keeper of the prison paid no attention to anything that was in Joseph's charge because the Lord was with him. And whatever he did, the Lord made it succeed. Our obedience may cost us something, but God will never leave us empty-handed. He got us covered always, and He will provide a way for us always. Diba? At this time, dun sa moment na kinulong si Joseph, it might look like it is the end for his life. But no. This is where he took his stopover or pause. At bakit? Para saan ba yun? Diba? Everything, every season in our life was meant to be there for a specific purpose. Even our stopovers. And here, I'll present you the three purposes of stopover. Ang tatlong purpose ng stopover, number one, rest. Number two, pause. And number three, go. Punta muna tayo sa rest. Diba, as far as we can remember, si Joseph ay binenta ng mga kapatid niya, tama? And then, he worked for his master, and then saka siya na-promote into becoming an overseer. Have you ever imagined that kind of journey? Napaka-exhausting noon, nakakapagod, and during that time, hindi niya kasama yung family niya. This journey that we have, which is fulfilling our purpose, glorifying God, and sharing the gospel, is indeed a lifelong journey, and it is also a lifelong committed. We might find ourselves along the way na napapagod or nauugos, but to tell you, normal lang po ang mapagod. Ang pagod ay kayang ipahinga, and it should not be a reason to stop. You may rest for a while because God also did it on the seventh day, pero after noon, back to work ka na ulit. And that is the first purpose of stopover, rest. Punta naman tayo sa pangalawa, which is yung pause. If you will have a remote control right now that can control everything at may isa ka lang na button na kailangan mong pindutin, what would it be? Ako personally, I will press the pause button. It is because pause is somehow a comma that will let you breathe in the middle of the statement. And this pandemic, di ba, ay nakaka-stress na rin, tama? Opinions are here and there, rants everywhere, tapos problems surrounding us, and the chaos of the world is getting worse. And as a citizen, you might have been tired of all this, but you know what? You can pause for a while. Kasi alam naman natin na ang race na to, along this journey, is hindi po paunahan sa finish line. This race is about endurance and perseverance, at kung nakalimutan mo ng huminto saglit at huminga, malabong marating mo ang dulo ng may hininga ka pa. And that is the second purpose of stopover, pause. Dako na tayo sa pangatlo, which is yung go. Joseph used the time given to him not just to rest or pause for a while, but also a chance to go back to his vision. When you are lost along the way, try to go back to the path you are meant to go to. And what happened to Joseph is what he used to go towards to the plan of God for his life. The only thing that you need to go back is your vision. And the only thing that you need to go towards is the plan of God for you. Sa Filipino, vision lang ang binabalikan. At plano lang ng Diyos ang dapat na pinupuntahan. Hindi na yung ibang iniisip mo ang babalikan at pupuntahan, na. Okay, so there you go. Those are the three purposes of stopover. Pero ang tanong, ano ba ang ginagawa dun sa mga stopover? Commonly, di ba, ang mga passengers, pupunta sila sa nearest comfort room, magpapahinga, mag-stretching, di ba, at kakain, di ba, magsasaya-saya yung mga yan. These things that we do during stopover is important too, because it will affect our return to the journey. Imagine, hindi ka kumain sa stopover knowing na mabilis na lang ang biyahe. But because of some delay, matagal-tagal pa at wala nang ibang stopover. So, what will happen to you right now, di ba? Gutom ka. Okay, so ngayon, i-discuss natin yung mga bagay na dapat mong gawin during your stopover. And we have the acronym CPR. Letter C, things to do during stopover. Number one is, contemplate with God more. According to Genesis 39 verse 21 and 33, basahin natin, but the Lord was with Joseph and showed him steadfast love and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. Verse 23, the keeper of the prison paid no attention to anything that was in Joseph's charge because the Lord was with him. And whatever he did, the Lord made it succeed. Contemplate means to meditate. So, ibig sabihin, during your stopover, we must improve our relationship with God more. We can say that meditating God's Word and His presence is like feeding yourself with food during the stopover or refilling the car with fuel. If you forget this, problems will arise along the journey like being hungry or losing fuel. Because of Joseph's commitment to God, he provided favor and whatever he did, the Lord made it successful. If you haven't forgot your first priority, which is God, He will also show you that you are His priority too. And that's letter C, contemplate with God more. Let's proceed to the letter P in the things we need to do during stopover, is practice your gifts. Let's read Genesis 40 verse 5 to 8. And one night they both dreamed, the cupbearer and the baker of the king of Egypt, who were confined in the prison. Each his own dream, and each dream with its own interpretation. When Joseph came to them in the morning, he saw that they were troubled. Troubled nga. So he asked Pharaoh's officer who were with him in custody in his master's house, "Why are your faces downcast today?" They said to him, "We have had dreams, and there is no one to interpret them." And Joseph said to them, "Do not interpretations belong to God? Please tell them to me." Since Joseph has a very intimate relationship with the Lord, he knows his gifts and he knows how God speaks. Kasi kapag mahal mo, kilala mo at kikilalanin mo. And that is what Joseph did. Therefore, he knows how God speaks. And at this time, he understood that the dream that he had before na sinabi niya sa mga kapatid niya was also from God. Kaya naiintindihan niya na parte ng plano yung nangyayari sa kanya. And at this time, he was also given a chance to practice what has been given to him as a gift from the Lord. And he grabbed it and talagang pinractice niya yung gift niya. Diba kung babasahin natin yung Genesis 40 verse 9 to 13, "So the chief cupbearer told his dream to Joseph and said to him, 'In my dream, there was a vine before me, and on the vine, there were three branches. As soon as it budded, its blossom shot forth, and the clusters ripened into grapes. Pharaoh's cup was in my hand, and I took the grapes and pressed them into Pharaoh's cup and placed the cup in Pharaoh's hand.' Then Joseph said to him, 'This is the interpretation. Three branches are 3 days. In 3 days, Pharaoh will lift up your head and restore you to your office, and you shall place Pharaoh's cup in his hand as formerly when you were his cupbearer.'" Joseph first interpreted the dream of the cupbearer of the Pharaoh, and then the chief baker followed. Dito sa Genesis 40 verse 16 to 22. When the chief baker saw that the interpretation was favorable, he said to Joseph, "I also had a dream that there were 3 cake baskets on my head, and in the uppermost basket there were all sorts of baked food for Pharaoh, but the birds were eating it out of the basket on my head." And Joseph answered and said, This is the interpretation. The 3 baskets are the 3 days. In 3 days, Pharaoh will lift up your head from you and hang you on a tree, and the birds will eat the flesh from you. On the 3rd day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, he made a feast for all his servants and lifted up the head of the chief cupbearer and the head of the chief baker among his servants. He restored the chief cupbearer to his position, and he placed the cup in Pharaoh's hand, which was in the dream of the cupbearer. But he hung the chief baker as Joseph had interpreted to them. During the idle moments of our journey, we can do a lot of things. Pwede tayo mag-scroll sa FB, mag-tweet, sumayaw sa TikTok, manood ng Netflix, or tawanan yung mga memes na nakikita natin online. Pero sana naman, hindi mo nakakalimutang i-practice yung kung saan ka pinagpala. Practice what you have. If you are given with a very beautiful voice, huwag mong hayaan na mawala yan, alagaan mo at palaguin. If you are gifted to lead, do not let the quarantine stop you from practicing that. And if you are gifted to serve, patuloy ka lang maglingkod at huwag ka magpapapigil. Let that gift that is given to you flourish by using it more often. Kasi ang bagay na hindi nagagamit ay nakakalawang at nawawala ng silbi. Use it still for the glory of God. And that is letter P. Practice your gifts. Just like what Joseph did, which is yung gift niya in interpreting dreams. Dako na tayo sa last letter, which is letter R, in the things that we need to do during stopover, which is remember God's promises. Basahin natin yung Genesis 40 verse 14-15. Ito yung time na na-interpret na ni Joseph yung dream ng dalawang tao, yung cupbearer at yung baker. Okay, sabi niya, "Only remember me when it is well with you. And please do me the kindness to mention me to Pharaoh, so get me out of this house. For I was indeed stolen out of the hand of the Hebrews, and here also I have done nothing that they should put me into the pit." While Joseph was able to interpret the dream of the cupbearer and the chief baker, nasa kanya pa rin yung burden ng lahat ng nangyayari sa kanya. He was so desperate to go back home and prove his innocence to every people na nag-isip ng mali sa kanya. Because he was wrongly accused by his brothers as well as his master. And mentioning him to the Pharaoh might be the only way for him to get out of the situation. And nung dumating na yung Genesis 41, this is where Joseph interpreted the dream of the Pharaoh na about the warning that the famine will come. And then Egypt was able to prepare because of the interpretation of God through Joseph. At dahil doon, Genesis 41 verses 37 to 40, this proposal pleased Pharaoh and all his servants. And Pharaoh said to his servants, "Can we find a man like this, in whom is the Spirit of God?" Then Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Since God had shown you all this, there is none so discerning and wise as you are. You shall be over my house, and all my people shall order themselves as you command. Only as regards the throne will I be greater than you." Because of Joseph's faithfulness with God, he has come this far to become trustworthy in the eyes of Pharaoh, and he earned his favor. And because of being trusted with small things, he became accountable on bigger things. Kaya every time we go along in this journey and sometimes we get tired, ang iniisip lang natin is yung pagod natin at yung pinagdadaan natin. At kapag di na natin kaya, we choose to give up. But always remember to go back to your fuel and to the food that will never make you go hungry. And that is the Word of God. Lagi ka lang babalik sa source mo at sa kung ano yung nagpapa-empower sa'yo. At ito na nga ang sumunod na nangyari. Genesis 41 verse 32 to 36. And the doubling of Pharaoh's dream means that the thing is fixed by God, and God will shortly bring it about. Now, therefore, let Pharaoh select a discerning and wise man, and set him over the land of Egypt. Let Pharaoh proceed to appoint overseers over the land, and take 1/5 of the produce of the land of Egypt during the 7 plentiful years. And let them gather all the food of these good years that are coming, and store up grain under the authority of Pharaoh for food in the cities, and let them keep it. That food shall be reserved for the land against the 7 years of famine that are to occur in the land of Egypt, so that the land may not perish through the famine. Yun yung sinabi ni Joseph matapos niyang interpretin yung dream ni Pharaoh. And Joseph did not boast about what he can do, but rather, he boasted on what God can do. And there, we saw how God blessed Joseph by putting him in charge of everything in the land of Egypt. Joseph remembered his God, and God showed him of his promises. And that is letter R sa ating things to do during stopover. Remember God's promises. So once again, ano ulit yung tatlong CPR na kailangan nating gawin? Number 1 is C, contemplate with God more. Letter P, practice your gifts. And letter R, remember God's promises. Yung CPR na yan, di ba parang CPR is a method we use wherein we try to revive someone who's maybe from drowning or suffocation. Minsan, we also need CPR in life along our journey to be revived and to continue what we have started. At yun, natapos na natin ang topic natin sa stopover. Palakpakan naman! But I am ending with this challenge. Along this journey, we will encounter tough situations, and sometimes we are pushed to push a break to take a moment of safety. Mahalaga rin minsan na tumigil, pero hindi para sumuko, kundi para pagpahinga, tumahimik, at mag-reflect. If ever you are having a hard time not knowing what to do next, just take your stopover and do the CPR. And when you're done, don't forget to get back on track and walk again, ah. So yun, that's it for today's topic. Ang dami nating natutunan. And before we end, let's close our eyes and pray. Lord, thank you for this day, for this time na natutunan namin ang purpose ng stopover at kung ano yung mga kailangan naming gawin during this stopover. Lord, allow us to have an intimate relationship with you more, to practice our God-given gifts, and also to remember your words and promises. Panginoon, at this pandemic, allow our hearts to have faith and peace, Panginoon, Lord God, kahit na anuman yung problema ang nangyayari. Salamat po, Panginoon, and nawa ma-apply po namin yung mga natutunan namin today. Thank you, Lord. This is all we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. So, thank you so much, guys. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel, Youth on the Rock. See you next topic. Bye-bye.